Welcome back to our second video in the series. Now for this one, we're going to go over the settings available to us in AXIOM Process for Magnet AXIOM Cyber. This is something we need to cover before getting into the various ways to create a new case or to work with an existing case and process data and bring it into our installation of AXIOM Cyber. Understanding how the settings work, optimizing things for our particular installation can be extremely beneficial for examiners. To go into the settings information in even further detail, the Magnet Forensics Training offers the CY200 course where you'll cover each of the settings in depth. Now to get to the settings menu for AXIOM Process, I'll actually just go up and select the Tools menu and then choose the Settings option. And we'll just work our way through the list here. Now the first one is our default case type. And we'll see this in a moment when we go and create a new case within AXIOM Process. Now the default behavior is for no default case type to be selected. This can be particularly useful, though, if you find yourself working one of the case types listed here, and the options available will vary based on the licensing that you have and whether you've enabled some of the additional features for AXIOM Cyber pertaining to child exploitation investigations like I have in this installation. But if you find yourself repeatedly working the same type of case, it may be easier to just select that so that it's pre-populated for you each time you create a case. You could always change it with each new case that you create. The next section here deals with remote acquisition within AXIOM Cyber. The default behavior is for the agent that is utilized for remote acquisition to be created and stored at the root of your system drive. If you'd like to use another location, you can select the Browse option there. Anything within AXIOM Process or AXIOM Examine that is a blue color like that is a hyperlink. You can click on that to obtain, in this case, it would be an Explorer dialog, so you can designate the location where you'd like to store the agent. Next to that, there is an option regarding agent removal. Specifically, when the remote acquisition is complete, do you want to automatically delete that agent from the remote computer? I'll scroll down a bit here. We can see we have some options related to compression. If we would like to compress the data that is acquired during that remote acquisition before transferring it across the network, we have the option to do that. And as with anything involving compression, there is a trade-off. There's some processing overhead to perform that compression, which does happen on the remote computer. Once it's completed, though, it does mean generally we get faster transfer speed of that now compressed data. And then we have options related to our logical acquisition container. Again, with regard to remote collections, do we want to store that data in an AFF4L or just a zip file? We'll scroll down a little more. The next section here deals with imaging, specifically with regard to acquiring images from our evidence sources using AXIOM Process. Now we have the option here to segment our images based on different optical media formats, or if we wanted to use a specific custom size and just enter something there in gigabytes, we could choose to do that so that our acquired images are now segmented. If we choose to not do this and we'd prefer to just have everything acquired in each image file just be one single file, we could just leave that at the default option there of none. Next to that, options for image hashing. Now by default, AXIOM Process, of course, will calculate the hash value of your source items before conducting the imaging operation. If you would like to also verify the hash of your acquired image of any source files, this only applies to E01 image formats. You can check the box here, just simply click in the box, and now all acquired E01s will be hashed to ensure there's a match between the original source and the new evidence container. The next option here deals with compression regarding E01 image format. Of course, like we talked about with compression and remote acquisition, there's some processing overhead. If we do compress our images, we've got to deal with not only the CPU cycles it takes to process the data to begin with, but also when we work with that data. It's got to be decompressed before our tools, AXIOM Process in this case, can do anything with it. The options here are none, obviously, for no compression. And then if we wanted to make this E01 container as small as it can be, we could use best compression, which probably incurs a greater processing overhead than certainly than no compression, but even more so than fast compression, which is kind of a balance between no compression and best compression, where we get some compression, so a smaller evidence container, but not as big of a hit to performance as we would with the best compression option. Scrolling down, the next option here deals with restoring the mobile device state. Now, an acquisition agent is used by AXIOM Process when acquiring data from Android devices in certain circumstances. This option provides examiners the choice of whether to remove the agent at completion of data acquisition or to leave it on the device. Below that, we have our cloud acquisition container. This simply lets us select the format or the container type of our acquired cloud data. Again, we've got the option to use AFF4L or a zip file. All right, let's scroll down, and the next section has to do with processing options. Now, the first one here is for temporary file location. By default, temporary files that are created by AXIOM Process during case processing are stored in the case folder. You are given the option here to select a custom location, which gives you a browse link, which will then take you to an Explorer window where you could designate a different location. This is an opportunity to improve performance if additional high-speed storage devices are available on your system. Below that is an option for image hash verification. Again, with regard to E01 and AFF4 evidence containers, if you'd like to verify the hash value of each of those items at the conclusion of evidence scanning procedures by AXIOM Process, you have the option to do that. And the next option has to do with duplicates. And this one certainly causes confusion at times. This option is not to be interpreted as removing duplicate copies, you know, binary copies or hash matches of the same file, which could exist in multiple locations within your evidence sources. AXIOM Process does not treat those items as duplicates. Instead, while AXIOM Process is scanning your evidence items, there are certain operations which could result in multiple hits for the same item. Leaving this option selected will remove those duplicate hits, which are discovered via those various processing options. Below that is an option for logging. AXIOM Process can collect log information that you can use to help track progress and troubleshoot potential issues. Turning on logging can impact performance. We'll scroll down a bit, and the next two sections have to do with processing speed. The first one is specific to overall search speed. Again, as mentioned in an earlier module, AXIOM Cyber is a very multi-threaded application, which supports the use of up to 32 logical CPU cores. The drop-down menu here allows examiners to limit the number of CPU cores AXIOM Process is using. If you intend to process evidence and you want it done as quickly as possible, selecting the maximum number of cores available on your system, up to 32 logical cores, will help to facilitate that. If you'd like to continue using that computer for other applications while you have AXIOM Process running and scanning your evidence items, you could simply select a lower number of overall cores to allow AXIOM Process to use. Below that is an option dealing with memory analysis search speed. By default, AXIOM Process will spawn as many instances of volatility for processing memory images as your computer will support. Similar to the feature for limiting CPU cores for search speed discussed previously, if you would like to continue using the computer for additional tasks, you can limit the number of instances of volatility accordingly. And our next option is regarding YARA rule set folders. By default, AXIOM Process will look for YARA rules within the Magnet AXIOM Cyber installation folder. However, you can choose to add additional locations if you have other rule sets stored elsewhere. Scrolling down, we'll move into some of our options dealing with hashing. File size limit for hashing. If desired, you can check this option and specify an overall limit for the size of the file that you're going to hash during case processing. Next, there's an option for hash formats. Now, by default, MD5 is selected. Examiners can use this option to select between MD5, SHA-1, or both MD5 and SHA-1 as appropriate for your use case. Next is an option for hash value storage location. Examiners can use this option to designate where AXIOM Process hash databases are stored. Now, by default, all hashes, whether imported for inclusion or exclusion purposes, are stored in the program data folder on the default system drive. Below that is an option to enable photo DNA. The link provided here allows law enforcement personnel to request access to the photo DNA features embedded within AXIOM Process. Once completed and photo DNA registration is approved, a code will be returned that can be copied and pasted into the text entry form shown here. Scrolling down, we'll take a look at our AXIOM Process settings. First is diagnostic information. Now, you can choose to share information about how you use the product with Magnet Forensics. This is telemetry data, and the information can help us improve our products. The type of information that gets sent can include data about how long it took to perform a search and the processing options you used in the search. The information that does get sent never includes actual data from the evidence sources that you search. There's an option here to automatically check for software updates each time you launch AXIOM Process. If you turn this option off, you must manually check the customer portal for updates. Below that are options related to passware encryption features. Using a third-party plugin available from Passware, AXIOM Process supports the recognition and full disk decryption of drives with a known password or recovery key. When you turn this feature on, future updates to AXIOM Process will also include these passware plugins. The next option allows examiners to decide if they would like AXIOM Cyber to provide a warning when starting AXIOM Process and antivirus software is running. Below that, we have features for local area network connection settings. If your agency requires that you use AXIOM Process through a proxy server, you can still use AXIOM Cloud to acquire user account data from certain cloud platforms. When AXIOM Process detects a proxy internet connection, it automatically connects to the server using the proxy settings on your computer or prompts you to type your credentials for the server, if applicable. Scrolling down, we have the option to enable additional AXIOM features. Selecting this option enables additional features in AXIOM Cyber focused on media categorization, support for gray key images, additional magnet AI categorization types, and other features primarily suited to the investigation of child exploitation material. A knowledge base article is linked in the video description for further details. Below that, users have the option to select the language used within the user interface of AXIOM Process. Simply select one of the options listed in the drop-down menu. And finally, product integration currently supports enabling Hash Sets Manager, which provides a method to easily manage a central database of hash sets that can be used across multiple installations of AXIOM Cyber. An article detailing further information about the Hash Sets Manager is also included in the video description. As a reminder, the Magnet Forensics CY200 training course provides additional information and goes into complete detail on each of the options covered within the settings menu of AXIOM Process.